opportunity to attend this meeting. I plan to present some results on fixed point for firmly non-expansive mapping in geodesic spaces, which could be used to better understand some results on the convergence of some algorithms which recently has been introduced in this setting. I will start by introducing some well-known facts about firmly non-expansive mapping in Hilbert spaces and fixing some notation and concepts on a space of bounded curvature. And in the second part, I will present some results about the asymptotic behavior of the Picard iterate for firmly non-expansive mapping. It's a very well-known fact that if we have a Hilbert space and we have a lower semi-continuous convex function, we can define the resolvent of the function. And the resolvent of the function is a firmly non-expansive mapping. And the fixed point of this mapping are the solution of the minimization problem associated to the mapping F. So if, to understand the algorithm to approach the minimizer of the function F is basic to understand the asymptotic behavior of firmly non-expansive mapping. There are different definitions of firmly non-expansive mapping. They were introduced by Browder for Hilbert space, later for Ronald Bragg in the setting of Banach spaces, and Reich introduced this mapping in hyperbolic spaces. But the fact is that all these definitions in the case of Hilbert spaces are equivalent. So the first definition is that a mapping is firmly non-expansive mapping in a Hilbert space if satisfy this inequality, where the interior product of the Hilbert space is strongly used in the definition. In the case of the Hilbert space, this is equivalent to the mapping being a convex combination of a non-expansive mapping, an average mapping with constant 1/2. This is also equivalent in the case of the Hilbert space to this mapping being non-increasing. This is the definition that can be, for instance, used in the setting of hyperbolic space, and is also equivalent to the mapping satisfying this inequality. This inequality is related to what usually is called in the theory the mapping being strongly attractive. The fact is that all these definitions are equivalent in Hilbert space, but this is no more true in Banach spaces. Of course, the definition A have no sense if we are not in a Hilbert space, but for instance, definition B and C are not in general equivalent in norm spaces. One interesting thing is the fact that firmly non-expansive mapping are not close under composition. But average mapping are close under composition. So what is true, and this is the relevant from the point of view of the behavior or the asymptotic behavior, is that the fact that the composition of firmly non-expansive mapping in the case of Hilbert spaces is average. the result about the asymptotic behavior of firmly non-expansive mapping has been proved by different authors, and basically I graph in this result what I consider are the most important. If we have a closed convex subset of a Hilbert space and we take up an arbitrary point X, then if we consider this is the so-called displacement of the mapping, that is the infimum of the distance between the point X and the image, then we have this equality. This equality gives a lot of information. For instance, if this is equal to zero, then we have that the mapping in particular is asymptotically regular. That is the case when the mapping has bounded orbit. In this case can be proved that the mapping has fixed point and the Picard iterator converge weakly and the mapping is asymptotically regular. What that means, this limit is equal to zero. And also is known that the rate of asymptotic regularity is quadratic. In the case that the orbits are unbound, the fact is that the Picard iterator diverges to plus infinity. So this is the result for the case of Hilbert space about the asymptotic behavior. In recent years, as I commented at the beginning, some algorithm to solve some minimization problem has been extended from the setting, the linear setting, to nonlinear setting, mainly to Hadamard manifolds and geodesic spaces. And when the author studied this extension, sometimes implicitly used firmly non-expansive mapping. For instance, there is a work of Jos about harmonic mapping where he studied the approximation of the solution of a convex functional, and then he introduced the notion of the resolving, and although he didn't use the concept of firmly non-expansive mapping, in some sense, implicitly some of the properties of this mapping are in the work. Also, in the extension of the proximal point algorithm to the setting of Riemannian manifold, the concept of firmly non-expansive mapping has appeared in some works. Let me recall some notions about geodesic spaces. If we have a metric space, we say that a geodesic is a mapping which goes from the interval 0L to the space where L is the distance between X and Y, and satisfying this property, the image is called a geodesic segment. The metric space is sec unically geodesic is given 2 points, there is a unique geodesic joining the 2 points. And the other notion we are going to use is the concept of convexity in this setting. We are going to say that a set is convex if given 2 points in the set, the segment, the unique segment joining the 2 points is contained in the set. So in particular, we are going to focus in this talk in geodesic space with non-positive curvature, the so-called cut zero space. Although I will comment later some of the results we are going to present here can be extended to more general setting, a space with, in general, curvature bounded above. So let me recall the, just a quick notation. If we have a segment XY, we are going to denote by this symbol the point that the distance from X to the point is T, the distance between X and Y. So the definition of cut zero space. We are going to say that a unique geodesic space is a geodesic space if satisfies this inequality. It's called the CN inequality, where this point is the middle point. Basically, what we have in this inequality is the fact that if we have two points, X and Y, and we consider the middle point in the geodesic, and we consider an arbitrary point here, in some sense, there is a control of this distance through this distance and this distance. There is another equivalent way to introduce cut zero space that I am going also to mention, because later on when I will speak about the extension of the result, it will be useful. This property is equivalent to the following one. If we consider three points in the space X, and we consider in the Euclidean space a triangle such that the length of the side are similar to this one, and if we consider two points in this triangle, and we consider the corresponding one here, this distance is less or equal than this distance. In this case, we say that the space is a cut zero space. Instead of consider the Euclidean space, we consider, for instance, the sphere that is a Riemannian manifold with is constant sectional curvature equal one, and we assume the same inequality, then we have the cut one space. So this is the natural way to introduce this space. This is way. So this is the definition of cut zero space. And now the definition of weak convergence. There are in the setting of geodesic space, there are different notions of weak convergence. We are going to use here one that actually can be used in any metric space. This was introduced by Lin, basically used the notion of asymptotic radius of a sequence. If we have a sequence and we call, we define the asymptotic radius. We consider in some sense is the best asymptotic center for the sequence. The point where this radius is attained are called the asymptotic centers of the sequence. Okay, so we will say that the sequence xn converges to a point if this point is the only asymptotic center of all the subsequence of the sequence. And then we will call this point the delta limit of the sequence. Actually, this notion in the case of Hilbert space coincides with the normal definition of weak limit, and in the setting of cut zero space coincide with another notion of weak limit which has been introduced in this setting. So this is the notion of weak convergence, and now we are going to introduce the notion of the firmly non-expansive mapping for cut zero space. What we are going to use is basically one of the characterization of firmly non-expansive mapping in the case of Hilbert space that makes sense in the case of geodesic space. That is this one. This is very easily translated. So using this characterization, we define what is a firmly non-expansive mapping in the case of cat zero spaces. The main thing is that, as happened in the linear case, any sunny non-expansive retraction is firmly non-expansive mapping. In particular, the metric projection is firmly non-expansive mapping. And the other important example, as happened in the case of Hilbert space, if we have a lower semi-continuous convex function and we consider the resolving, then the resolving is also a firmly non-expansive mapping in the case of cat zero spaces. So basically, the two main examples in the case of Hilbert space also are examples in the more general case of cat zero spaces. So our first result is about the asymptotic behavior of firmly non-expansive mapping for cat zero space. In this case, we have the SAT counterpart of the result in the Hilbert space. We have that, as happened in the Hilbert case, if we consider the minimal displacement measures the asymptotic behavior of the Picard iterates of any firmly non-expansive mapping. Using this result, we can also give in particular, observe here that if the orbits are bounded, then the mapping is asymptotically regular. And then, in this case, we can provide some rate of asymptotic regularity for the mapping. What about the composition? Composition of firmly non-expansive mapping appear in a natural way in many minimization problems. For instance, in the first talk of this section, the speaker was presenting some result about the convex flexibility problem. In the convex flexibility problem, what appear basically is the composition of many projections. So in the end, what appear is the behavior of the composition of firmly non-expansive mapping. This is a natural problem where composition of firmly non-expansive mapping must be considered in the case of Hilbert spaces. Here is exactly the same because we have noticed that in the case of cat zero space, the metric projection are also firmly non-expansive mapping. But also there are more general problems. For instance, this one, if we have two lower semi-continuous convex mapping, and we consider the problem of minimizing this function, then in the case of Hilbert space, has been proved that under some condition, if one consider the resolving of the mapping F, and then one consider the resolving of the mapping G, and then we apply one and then the other one in a cyclic way, in the end, we can approach a solution of this problem. So in this case, what appear are the resolving of this mapping, and the composition. And what is necessary is to study the composition of the two resolvents. A particular case is the case of the when we have two sets and we want to study the convex feasibility problem for two sets. In this case, it's easy to see that if we consider the as a mapping F, the characteristic function of the set A, and a mapping G, the characteristic function of the mapping B, what we obtain if we apply the resolving of the mapping F first and the resolving of the mapping G later is just the alternating projection method. So, motivated by this fact, it's natural to try to obtain results for the composition of firmly non-expansive mapping in the case of geodesic space. The problem for the composition, as we commented at the beginning, in the case of Hilbert space is in some sense very easy, because although the composition of firmly non-expansive mapping is not close, and the the composition of two firmly non-expansive mapping is not a firmly non-expansive mapping, what is true that the composition is average. It's very well known that the Picard iterates of average mapping converge. So in the Hilbert case, from the theoretic point of view, there is no problem. In the case of Banach space, this is not true, and actually Ronald Bragg and Simon Reich, to study the problem, use another notion, that was the notion of a strongly convex function, a strongly non-expansive mapping, sorry. And using this notion, they study the composition. But the problem is this notion is a very linear notion and is not useful. So to study the problem in a non-linear setting, we need to use another kind of argument. So using this argument, we study the problem. We consider a finite family of mapping, and given a arbitrary point, we define a sequence applying successively the different mappings, and we do admitting the possibility of some errors. What we can prove is the following. If we have an arbitrary number of firmly non-expansive mapping in ACAT zero space, under this assumption, this is a strong assumption, that the intersection of the fixed point set associated with each mapping is not empty. In this case, what we can prove if we give any starting point, then the sequence defined is delta convergent to some fixed point. If in addition some of the rank of the mapping is boundedly compact, then the convergence is strong. Also, we can prove that the sequence is asymptotically regular, and also we can provide some rate of asymptotically regularity. So in this case, as I commented, this result can be proved in a more general setting. We just need to assume on the space some kind of uniform convexity, a strong uniform convexity. On the mapping also we can relax the condition. So that, for instance, we can prove the convergence of the alternating projection method for the convex feasibility problem for cat k spaces. This result has been proved previously just for a space of non-positive curvature. So in this case, we generalize the result, the known result. But as I commented, in this case, we assume that the fixed point of the intersection being no empty. This assumption is very strong in some problems. Not, for instance, in this problem, because in this problem it's natural in some cases consider this condition. But of course, even in this problem, if we consider the case where the intersection is empty, then we don't have this condition. And actually, if we think in this problem has sense when the two resolvents have no common fixed points. Because in the other case, it's elementary. So what happened, we can prove a similar result, but just for two mappings, and just for the case of cut zero space, for the case where the we don't know that the common fixed point, the set of the common fixed point is non-empty. So what we prove is that we have a cut zero space and we have two firmly non-expansive mapping, and we consider a point x0 and we consider the sequence defined using the mappings t1 and t2 in this way, applying first t1 and then t2, then we obtain that if this set is empty, then the two sequences are unbounded. And if the set is non-empty, this is a weaker condition that the set of the common fixed point being non-empty, then we have that the both sequences are asymptotically regular, and in particular that the sequence delta converge to a pair of points that are in some sense U and TU, where U is a fixed point of this mapping. Additionally, if the image is boundedly compact, then we can prove that the convergence is strong. In particular, if we apply this problem, this result to the following problem. Suppose we have two sets that are not empty and closed, and we want to study the problem of finding point A and B such that the distance between the set A and B is attained in this point. Okay? So, actually, if we consider as a mapping T1 the projection, the metric projection on B, and T2 the metric projection on P1, then applying the previous theorem, we can prove that there is, if this set is non-empty, a point such that the sequence Sn converges to A and the second Yn converges to B, delta converges. If we assume that one of the sets is compact, then the convergence is strong. Observe that in particular, we know that this set is non-empty, for instance, if one of the sets are bound. So let me to illustrate our result in some particular case.
Yes.
I am going to try to finish. If we consider, for instance, the Poincaré plane, and in this case we are considering two sets. The set A is this semicircle that is a geodesic, and this vertical line that is a geodesic. Here we have the three cases. In this case, the intersection is non-empty, and of course, if we project, the projection converges to the common fixed point. In this case, the intersection is empty, but there is two points where the minimal distance is attained. And in this case, we can prove that the alternating projection converges to the point of the minimal distance. And in the last case, these two sets, in this case, the minimal distance is not attained, because if you consider the Poincaré distance here, the distance tends to zero when the point tends to infinite. In this case, the two mapping doesn't converge. Okay, so just to say that the results regarding the behavior of firmly non-expansive mapping can be found in this paper about the composition of mapping, firmly non-expansive mapping. This is not true. This is under review at the moment. And information about optimization in geodesic space, I think this is a good reference. Okay, that is all. Thank you very much. So, any questions?